बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमान अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू ब्रिलियम्स ऑनलाइन साइंस क्लास फॉर ग्रेड टू। ओपन अ पेज नंबर 32, राइट डाउन डेट डेट एंड अ डे ऑन द टॉप। टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज यूनिट 5, दैट इज एनिमल्स। वेल यू सी एनिमल्स ऑल अराउंड यू, एनिमल्स आर डिफरेंट साइजेस एंड आर डिफरेंट काइंड्स। एनिमल्स ब्रीद, मूव एंड ईट, दे रिप्रोड्यूस एंड दे डाई एज वेल। एनिमल्स कैन बी इन लिविंग इन डिफरेंट एरियाज लाइक इन जंगल्स एंड एट वी कीप देम इन होम्स एज वेल, इन फार्म्स एज वेल। सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी देम। देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ एनिमल्स, डोमेस्टिक एंड वाइल्ड। एंड देर आर एनिमल्स, डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द एनिमल्स विच दे यूज फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पसेज, फॉर प्रोटेक्टिंग देमसेल्व्स एंड फॉर फीडिंग देमसेल्व्स। सो लेट्स स्टडी। Many animals live on the earth, some live on land, some like fish live in water. So some insects live in the grass and many can fly. Birds make their nest in trees. Okay, so these are the different places where you can find the animals. Animals live in different places and in different ways. Like some live in water, dolphin, jellyfish, octopus, these are all animals living in water. Then there are animals which live on land, like birds live in trees. There are giraffe, lions, and then there are insects as well which also live on land. Special body parts. Animals have different parts, body parts to help them live, find food and move. Birds have wings to fly. They have beaks to catch worms from the ground and eat grains. They have different kind of beaks. Some beaks are pointed, some are hooked. So we are going to study that. And they eat grains and seeds with the help of their beak. You can see a duck and a frog has webbed feet which help them in swimming. A giraffe has a long neck which helps it to eat leaves on tall trees. Then there are two kinds of animals, wild animals and domestic animals. Wild animals live in forest and jungles. Many wild animals eat plants. Some eat other animals. Wild animals cannot be kept at home. They are dangerous for you. Like lion. A lion, for its own protection, is going to eat other animals, and for its own food, it's going to eat other animals. Okay? So you are not going to keep a lion at your home. It can be dangerous for you. Then there are scavengers, such as the hyena, wild dog, and vulture. What they do, they eat other dead animals. That is why they have hooked beaks, which help them in tearing the dead animals apart and eating their flesh. So, and animals have different type of body parts. A lion has very sharp claws and very sharp teeth, which helps it in eating other animals. All right. Domestic animals, some animals can be tamed. They are called domestic animals. They can be kept at home. They live in our houses as pets. Others are kept as on the farms. They help us in many ways. For example, animals that kept in farms are like cows. They give us milk, like sheep. We can eat sheep. We can use wool of the sheep for making clothes. So similarly, pets are our friends, and they are useful too. Cats chase away mice. Yes, if you have mice at home, keep a cat, it will chase them away. Some domestic animals give us milk, for example goat and cow. Many people eat the flesh of these animals, like sheep, hen, fish, crab and turkey. These animals are all birds. They give us eggs, like hen, duck and goose. They give us eggs and we eat them too. These animals give us silk, wool, fur and leather. For example, a silkworm will help us in making silk scarf or dupatta. From cow we get leather jackets, and from sheep we get the wool for making our cardigans and sweater. Then there are baby animals, and many animals have babies that look like their parents. Other animals do not look like their parents. For example, frog and fish lay eggs in water, and baby fish are called fry, and baby frogs are called tadpoles. They do not look like their parents. This is a tadpole. It does not look like its parent. That is frog, adult frog. And horse and foal, bear and calf, swan and cygnet. Most animals have babies that look like their parents, and there are some babies which do not look like their parents. Let's talk about the pictures below. Where do these animals live? What they do? What they eat? And what do they use these parts for? So you are going to go through them and find the answers. Let's discuss some of them. You see, animals that live in polar regions have thick fur and a lot of body fat to protect them from the cold. Monkeys have long tail, which helps them in swinging through trees. Camels have a large hump at the back, which has a fat which the camel uses when the food is not available. Tigers have sharp teeth, which help it in catching its prey, killing it and tearing it apart and eating the flesh. The horn of the rhinoceros and the antlers of the buck or deer helps it in protecting themselves from any kind of danger. This is the feather of peacock, which helps it in protecting itself when it is in danger. An eagle has a sharp beak, which helps it in catching its prey and eating it and tearing it. An elephant has a long trunk, which helps it in pulling the tree trunks and branches for eating its for eating the leaves. A fish has fins, which helps them in moving through water, and it has scales on its skin, which helps it in protecting its body. So these are the different body parts which animals use for eating and for protecting themselves. And similarly, in this chapter we have started that animals live on land, in water, and some can fly. Animals have special body parts which are used in different parts. Some animals are wild and others are tame. Tame animals help us in many ways. We get food and other useful products from animals. And we have also studied that some young animals look like their parents and others do not. So see you in another class. Till then, thank you.